listen, I'm not that happy about it. Because it's, I mean, I like this idea. I like the idea of a Naga in the safe lane, but I haven't seen it have a lot of success recently. And I think they've played it also. I might be wrong about that. Let me go back through their heroes. All right, no, I'm just kidding. They haven't played it. I'm wrong. I'm completely wrong, but that's okay.
That's going to be interesting. I think we're going to see actually like two dual lanes, and we're going to see the Bounty roaming middle. We're going to see the Shadow Demon roaming middle a ton this game. Yeah, that's going to be the action lane.
Dude, if you look at Complexity's draft, this looks like just a regular draft for them. This looks not like a Japanese draft, and more like a, oh, we're in CM, we're just going to get all heroes draft. Like, they are completely happy with this draft on the right hand side. God, Complexity are happy.
Yep, this should be... They're definitely, Complexity's definitely, they always play so good before the majors or any big LAN. They just need to start transferring it over to the LANs, and they're going to be starting to get that second NA invite to all the tournaments.
Yeah, and obviously they're a bit of a newer team with the addition of Chessy recently, so obviously they're still kind of gelling together, but I think now they're getting even more and more powerful as a team. Not only are they in the winner's bracket of this tournament, they're also in the winner's bracket of Canada Cup, which, as far as any teams are concerned, there's all of them there besides EG. And they're doing very well for themselves. They're actually one round away from the grand finals, so we'll see if they can make it there tomorrow. For this tournament, they want to get qualified for Captain's Draft 3.0. They want to move on. And with this draft, they're looking pretty solid. They'll grab the top rune spot for Limp. It's going to be the Bounty. Bottom will be grabbed by Weeha, the Lina. This is not going to be an easy matchup for Limp. This is a very good player, and for the reason, everyone now knows how good Weeha is. And he might struggle here early on, though. He is playing the puck, and we'll see. This is a very good hero in terms of laning ability, and a very good player as well. But we'll see how things go here mid.
Yeah, you saw also during the ban phase, they first banned Meepo people. I mean, you definitely got to do it in CD if you're doing it in CM.
Yeah, that's fair. It's a very good point, too. Oh, God. Pycat's going to get aggro tri-laned against. That's devastating. They're going to have the good old support Shadow Demon Lashrac duo, which is very strong. We've seen it a lot. But you could always queue out of that if Chessy gets put under. Oh, wait, no, I'm losing it. Shadow Demon Tree. All right, I lost it. Oh, that's still pretty good, though. It's not quite as good, but it's still something. Ooh, oh, that was so close. Z-Freak actually trying to get that ward. Dropped the sentry. Unfortunately, was not able to do much there, so it will get countered immediately, and that's okay. So this will leave Moskery down bottom against Swindomones in a solo versus a solo matchup. So obviously, a lot of the blood's going to be happening in the top tri lane, but there still is an interesting matchup down bottom, which should be... I think pretty good for Swindles, actually.
And they have the sentry down middle for Weeha, so he'll see him right now.
Oh yeah, there it is. Z-Freak. Sentry's gonna get dropped up. He's gonna eat the other sentry, so Z-Freak will be able to start roaming around a little bit more effectively, and Weeha will have a tougher time. Limp has 7 last hits, and Weeha has 6. Still very close, not much happening, but this aggro tri lane is where you have to keep your eyes on top lane.
And we did spot out Z-Freak on that hill, invising up and going around on him again, so nothing really gonna happen there.
Yeah, he's gonna sit on his side of the river over towards this side of the tower. And he'll have to just back up. Z-Freak will wait for the 2-minute rune. It is a double damage. He wants to go top of that. Might be pretty effective in getting that kill. There's no ward that will scout this out on the Dire side, so as they're pulling, they might get roamed on here. No sentry either. They already used the one to unblock the creep cannon, and Chessy will just roam on it and pop the Blade Fury. He'll just pop himself in that disruption. Now the splitter will come out, and that will be your first blood, and Z-Freak takes it very easy. I think Hans getting into the kill. Blast right click, but now Yaps are getting body blocked as well. Can they get this kill? Z-Freak, no Janana, but they have the Orb of Venom Soul. He's gonna eat his way through. Gets done up by the splitter. Beautifully done from Hanskin. They'll take 2. Complexity will get 2 quick kills here in this top lane, and already start assaulting this top lane.
That was perfect. Chessy literally just got his boots, ran at him, started spinning. It makes the Juggernaut use his Q right there, and I mean, sets up the stun for the Lashrac, even though he's on the opposite team. An easy kill.
That was the one thing I was really worried about, is just him. If he goes for a disruption on his own allies, they're going to get stunned. And you're going to see that consistently if they keep Hans get up here. So already this pays off, this aggressive tri lane. It doesn't stop the Naga from farming. She still has 10 last hits, but now they're getting some kills and some plenty of farm for their Juggernaut as well, who's got 10 last hits. And all the meanwhile, look at Min, 19 last hits for Lep. He's destroying this lane. Wow.
Yeah, he is. And Nature's Prophet's wing bottom. He has the phase boots up, so it's going to be impossible for Swindle to get a solo kill on him now. Which, I mean, could happen at 6, but doubtful now.
We thought gonna jump in or rather get jumped on by Limp. There's gonna be the silence up, but the LSA came out first and Limp's in trouble. Has to pop the fairy fire. He'll go down. Now the sprouts up in Z Freak as well. He's got his Shadow Walk at three, but now the Dragon Slayer will go. Two more right clicks will do the job. Can they get it done? Absolutely. The range of both of those heroes is outstanding. Complexity will lose two, including their mid Limp, as the silence came just a bit too late to stop Weehawk from popping up that LSA.
Yeah, that double stun on both of them when their stats spread out, that was pretty good stun.
Yeah, and that's going to turn things around. He'll get up to 90 last hits now. Limp will only lose last hit, but the death is pretty big. It's actually huge.
Yeah, they're really counting on Chessy up top here now, and he's got a 3v1 lane orange coming back now.
All right, well, I mean, it's not like the Naga's actually getting zoned out that badly. The 14 last hits for Chessy. Meanwhile, the Naga has 19. They have to find a way to kill her. Naga's level 4, so she's getting kind of close. Z-Freak is shadowing her, just trying to get some extra vision, maybe look for a potential initiation as they're clearing out that creep wave. Flycat might actually be in trouble here. Let's see if they go on him. Answer's yes. Chum will go under the jug. They don't have Hans getting to jump in with the Split Earth. Chessy's still chasing. Orb of Venom is up onto Z-Freak. They're going to chase even further. Then turn their attention towards Soxa. Say, okay, listen, let's find another target. They missed their Split Earth. They don't go for it. They went for the animation. You stopped it, saying, okay, that's a little bit too close to tower. They're going to back up, and Complexity will not be successful. Meanwhile, Podcat is now running at the rest of the squad. There's the Ensnare coming through as there's a TP coming in. That'll be from Moskiri. Moskiri's going to get caught. Split Earth will fly. It'll be on just the one. Now there's going to be the Blade Fury coming out. Soxa in some trouble, the Edict will fly as well. Everyone is so low on the side of Mama's Voice. They're probably gonna lose Moskiri here as they get off the Janata, as well as the Orb of Venom slow, but he gets off the Living Armor. He'll stay alive. The salve is up for Pycat. Another disruption coming out, and Chessy will get pushed back even further. Now this is coming in. They'll jaunt him through. He's got Dream Quill, but he's just too late to the party. And a lot of rotations and a lot of aggression for Complexity that do not really result in any specific kill whatsoever.
Yeah, a perfect sprout from Masquerade side, because I mean Blade Fury doesn't hit through sprout if you go to the opposite side, so he like used so much of his time there and they all just got away. Tree armor looking good.
Yeah, that tree and protector getting some experience elsewhere. He's in the jungle currently. Actually, it's Iron Talon jungling. This is not the first time I've seen this. I've seen this in pub games before. It actually is okay. I mean, it's not the worst thing that could happen, but he's in there, he's getting up his levels, he's trying to get some experience going his way. However, he'll be able to Living Armor from there. He's got 2 points into it now, so. Also, while this was happening, Swindle was getting free farm down bottom. He's up to 32 last hits now, but he doesn't quite have that Blink Tagger. Meanwhile, on the jungle, Sox is going to get caught out. Z-Freak's running in. Looking for that Janata proc, he'll find it. Sox will be slowed up. Here's the Illusory Orb. He does get the Tree Ant Protector's armor, but he will die quickly to Limp Silence and right clicks. So, free kill, they'll find it in the jungle.
Yeah, I mean, oh, top lane still, but he'll just run away. Yeah, Weehaw's had an amazing time middle now, but Swindle has bottom too with each other's lane partner going off to do something else.
So what do you do here now? If you're Complexity, do you wait for that Blink Dagger on Swindle, or do you decide to push a little bit earlier or fight a little bit earlier?
I think you just wait for the Blink Dagger and then you start 5-man like they're really good at, either going to take mid tower or that top tower. All they need is, I mean, I assume Chessy will, actually not sure what he goes for in this game. I see him go for Battle Fury a lot, or Sanji and Yasha.
With the start he has, maybe he doesn't go Battle Fury. Maybe
is it a rough one?
Yeah, and also against the Naga. So I guess against the Naga you go Battle Fury, but in this situation, I'm not entirely sure that's going to be the case. We'll wait and see what he gets.
Oh, this could be a good kill on Brown.
And here comes Z-Freak. Janata will fly the Orb of Venom. He's very fast with Phase Control. Sprout will come out beautifully done. Swiddle cannot bite his way through. There's no Quelling Blade or Tangle for him to eat through that tree line, and so that kill is actually going to be lost, at least for now. Masquerade is going to go back a little bit. He's got the Living Armor, and Pycat going to get zoned out. He doesn't have his level 6. He's very close. Same for Chess. He doesn't quite have that Omni Slash yet. Down bottom, rotating in. Lina's nearby. Weehaw. They have vision of him, maybe? They do not. Now they're going to go into Masquerade. Sprout will go up as well. He gets the clap as well. Now there's going to be the Nature's Wrath. LSA will fly. There's going to be the ultimate coming out from Swindle. Can they get this kill? The Living Armor will go. They'll lose Z-Freak. Masquerade is low, but not dead yet. The Cyclone up. That'll be on to Lina. And there's the Boulder Toss. We'll get the kill. But now, Swindle might actually be in trouble. Weehawk can grab him with this Laguna Blade. He does actually miss up the stun. The clap will fly. He'll try to turn on this. Meanwhile, Chessy gets the kill onto Soxa in the top lane, and we'll pick up Yopster as well in the tree line. They've lost three, they're looking for a fourth. That'll be Pycat, as Swindle's gonna disengage bottom lane. Pycat will run his way out of there, get towards that lane, And it is just going to be a 0-for-3 trade. Although, Leonid is going to kill bottom eventually with a Laguna Blade. So that trade does come into effect. But he does pick up his blade before dying. A huge play coming out for the rest of Complexity.
Yeah, they engaged on top while bottom was engaged on for Complexity. And then the Nature's Prophet ult hit them both for like 300. So they had to run away and they thought they left. But they both had health potions and just re-engaged. Got a bunch of kills, Chessie.
Oh. Oh yeah, Sprout came through. He's eating his way up, but he actually does have life grip if he needed it. And still have bought the healing ward. He bought the Aquila, so we still don't know what item he's going to be going for, but they're in a very good spot right now. Pycat is not significantly behind Chessie, but he's still a little bit down in terms of the net worth. And you can see three of the top four in net worth are on Complexity side. And really, they needed this Luna to come up big for Weeha. Again, this is going to be their ninth game in a row if they lose this one. Can't afford that, especially here in the winner's bracket finals coming up against Complexity squad. So also, yeah. Meanwhile, Yatra's just been generally good. That's been kind of interesting, but anyways.
Yeah, I think 9 losses in a row would make me feel pretty bad. We'll hope that they probably hope they can bring this win, bring up team morale a little bit. And hey, if they win 2 games in a row here, they just qualify for the tournament.
That's right. Yapster's going to get caught out. He's got Edict. They've got Clap. They're going to jump in. Spudif will fly. The living armor is now gone. And he doesn't have a Nature's Guise. He was not going to be able to survive that. Even if he did, they would have clapped him or killed him again. They're even going to roam looking for Weeha. If they can find Weeha, that's a huge kill. They do not want to dive the tier 2 tower, and I don't blame them for it. And they're just trying to find farm anywhere for Pycat. This is the biggest problem. They're really looking for a lot of farm for Pycat to be effective. Like, you need something like a Radiance, but he's kind of a ways away from that.
Yeah, when you pick a Naga that's not support, you're pretty much like, not all in on him, but you're putting a good chunk of your faith in him.
Yeah. I mean, this game's going to get much harder, too, when you have all these items coming out, all these abilities. Track will be here soon. Soxie was going to get chased down to that top lane. Chessie's still chasing after him, for God's sakes. The Courier will come out, Swindle will get off the clap, and he's just like, I just wanted to ward up, guys. Can you leave me alone? Just kidding, I guess I'm dead. And they'll get a kill. Easily done. So this Blink's actually destroying right now. They've gotten like 2 or 3 quick kills because of this Blink dagger for Swindle.
And look, they don't even have to push towers after kills. I mean, they want to, but they're fine just getting kills and farming up the rest of the map. Bottom lane tower, though.
Yeah, that might fall. Moskri hasn't actually done much in terms of pushing, but he will find a potential kill on Z-Freak. In Snare, it'll be the Song. It's too late! He TP's out in time. The Song for nothing. That long cooldown. 180 seconds now without a Song of the Siren. A Song of the Siren. They didn't get a kill off that kind of it. Now it's TP coming in. Swindle will rotate down bottom. Blink, Clap will find Mastery. Dreamcore will fly through. Illusory Orb. Waiting Rift. Is it their time? He's going to be able to TP out. He actually missed the silence as he was jaunting on through. So a kill missed on both sides with ultimates being expended. And so Complexity, they will keep their tower alive. However, could have been a lot better for them.
Yeah, and Chessie getting the tower up top, but I mean, yeah, good 2-versus-3 defense bottom from Complexity, and now that they have those early kills, they have an early lead, they can do those different fights because they have more farm.
Dude, I think Complexity, oh god, if Chessie goes for Blink, I'd be, okay, no, he went drum. All right, I was like, that's really strange if he just goes for Blink first. I agree with Blink, but not first, so I'm glad that he picked up another item. And this is very common, if you want to fight early, phase drum into like maybe an SMY, you could still go Battle Fury, but what are your thoughts on the drum purchase here for Complexity?
Oh, yeah, I think phase, Aquila drums are like the perfect 3 items for an early game Juggernaut.
Yeah.
Pink might be, oh, he backs up.
I think they knew. I'll make some mirror images and then back away. Maybe we saw him. There was no sentry ward here as the Z-Freak was entering the jungle, but speaking of drum, Weeha has one of his own, also with treads. And now the double damage rune bottle up, but they're going to make a go onto him. Blimp will jump in, silence will come out as well. They don't have Dream Core for 1 second. I'm not sure if they need it. They can go onto 2, Illusory Orb, Omnicide. Yapster walks into his death. Maybe not. The Shadow Demon will disrupt him. They'll back away. They need a Shuriken Toss. They'll find it. Limp will get a double kill. Soxie gets tracked as well. They dive it. Swindle jumps in. Absolutely. They'll take 3 kills in Complexity. Starting to run over Mama's Boys, Grant.
Yeah, this is looking a little bit rough. Swindle even picks up the 10-minute bottle. He didn't go Arcane. He's like, well, I need some sort of mana. And he's always there. I think we always say that when we watch him play. Yeah. Swindle's always in the right spot at the right time.
He really is. I would not have said this like two or three patches ago, or even two or three team iterations ago, but Swindle is, I think, one of the best offlaners in NA right now. That's not much to say, because I guess there are not many offlaners in NA, but he's pretty damn good, nonetheless.
Yeah, and even when he gets the goes to safe lane one-on-one against, like, a Nature's Prophet, he manages to find that, what, 8-minute blink?
Yeah, it was pretty solid. Obviously, the Nature's Prophet left lane, but still, it was not a conducive lane for him to get that early blink dagger, so it was pretty well done from him. Meanwhile, PyCat getting roamed down. There is a good Observer Ward that will scout them out, I think, running through the jungle, so he will back up. He does have Song at 20. He'll probably just TP out right now. I don't think he's... Yeah, he's going to TP back to the Tier 2 tower.
He went the mana boots, so he went for that so he can jungle a little bit quicker, since, I mean, all their lanes are going to just be pushed in. They're going to get 5-man by complexity. He's going to have to do that. I mean, he'll get Octarine eventually and disassemble him, but delaying your Radiance by that much when you're this far down...
Yeah.
It's not good.
Oh, ooh, they just get that kill on the Masquerade down bottom with Flynn popping the Dream Coil, getting the sounds off as well. I completely agree with you. Like, they're in a very rough spot. PyCat is nowhere near his Relic or even Radiance. And it's going to be tough because they're going to lose a lot of their outer towers here. But as long as they have, like, one set of racks to work on while he's got that Radiance, it might be okay. Swindle actually will go down. Weehaw gets the full combo off. Doesn't even have to pop the Drum Charge. Gets the LSA Dragon Slave Laguna Blade. That is enough to bring down one of the top net worth heroes. And Weehaw still keeping this game somewhat even as he's got third in net worth right now.
I just wonder if he's going to go Blink Dagger or just straight up Aghanim's Yules. So much you can do with Lina.
Yeah, I think Ags actually is not bad this game because there's Blade Fury. You want to be able to, if you can get Aghanim Scepter, you just kill
top lane.
Monskin might be in trouble. Here's the disruption coming in. Chase is going to run through as well. Soxka might be in trouble. There's the Silence. Lip comes out of nowhere. Pops up the Waning Rift. They do get the LSA off, and Chase is in trouble. Dragon Slayer on these ties will fly, but he's still in trouble. He's got his healing ward. He can't get it off in time. That's a huge kill. Now the Overgrowth. Lip will be able to jaunt away, but he's still getting chased down. He's got Plague. He'll be able to get onto his side of the river. TP coming through a little bit too late for Monskin. Meanwhile, Z-Freak and Hanskin way on the back lines. They have TPs. They might be able to get out, but they're looking for Weehaw. Z-Freak will find Yapzor instead, get the track up. Jump and Swindle. He does have his ultimate. Now Dust will fly through. Z-Freak in trouble. There's the Song, or Song of the Siren coming out. PyCat will get stunned up by that boulder toss. Yapzor getting chased down still. Very tanky. He pops up the Leech Skin as well. Now Hans getting in trouble as well. Splinter will fly. The Inic going to work. The Pulse Stone. Can they get these kills? Weehaw is low. The Destruction will come out. Swindle is still back into his regular form. The clap will come through the LSA. However, he might turn his life away. Dream Pro on it too. Now it's through the Elite getting in the top of the three. PyCat almost going down. They need a Shuriken Toss. They won't find it yet. Now Swindle in trouble. He'll fall. Z-Freak getting chased after. Shuriken Toss. This is the wrong one. He did get the track over the PyCat. He will fall. This is a 3-for-2 trade. I'm sure that's not the real end tally after this fight. There's a lot of kills here, but Mama's Boys will get the advantage. Finally, their first fight going their way.
Yeah, I think long fights like that are going to benefit when you have a Naga and a tree, and you have the tree healing, have that disruption, keep people under. They like those long, drawn-out fights.
Yeah. That was, I agree, like, you saw it too, like, the Leaving Armor used two or three times to Leech Seed, keeping people alive.
Does, I believe, Panda's, Air Spirit, the Urge takes off Living Armor, right?
It's
I didn't see him using it. He was focused on stunning that Naga, yeah. But couldn't get it off in time.
I think he got a Cyclone off, and I think he also got a Stun off for two. But other than that, no, I didn't see the Purge or whatever it's called actually used in that fight. But it should take off Living Armor. I think you're right. I'll have to look that up a little bit later.
And
but
that just bought a lot of time for the Naga Siren. He went from having that 700 gold in the mana boots to having 2.6k now.
That is huge. He's now about 1,000 away from getting that relic, which is a pretty big deal. He's 1-0-2 currently. They lost the courier in that team fight, but worse things have happened as they won the fight. They actually see PyCat farming here. Z-Freak's gonna walk through. PyCat will make some illusions. PyCat will also walk away. Chessy, by the way, this is gonna answer our question. He's gonna go for Battle Fury, and I'm completely okay with it considering who he's playing against.
I can't see Z-Freak, but he's trying not to give it away that he sees him.
Yeah, this is a solid bit. They're going to TP in Monster behind the tree line. The Ensnare will fly through. They get the dust off as well. He'll try to TP away. They've got the Riptide. They have no Song. Dream Coil will come through. Limp will come in silence. He actually might need to back away. He'll actually jaunt out. Jesse pops up the Omni Slice, but it's only level 2. He does get the kill on the PyCat, but now the Laguna Blade will fly through. This is turning into a full-fledged fight. They get off the ultimate coming out. The Overgrowth's going to work. The LSA will fly. They've lost two of their big cores, but Monster will be in trouble now. They pop up the ultimate. They'll try to get up, but there's going to be the bonus. They'll pick up two with a 2-for-2 trade. If they get Weehaw, this would be a great fight. But they've already lost Hoskins. Look how low Z-Freak is. And it's not going to come down to Swindle winning this fight on his own. And I don't think he can do it. Weehaw's going to go ahead and pop up his Shadow Blade. The throw up the boulder toss here. Weehazlo might die to a clap. The Elsa gets off. There's no mana for the clap five. It's Swindle. This might be a five-man wipe. Mama's boy's gonna turn this game around. They say, listen, this game is not over yet. They'll take up the fifth kill as Shoxa will come in, pop the beautiful Shadow Poison. Yapu will get off the lead seed, and the LSA coming up from Weeha. Big engagement coming up from Mama's boys. What a team fight as they get 2.6k gold grant after that one.
Yeah, that was all started from that perfect bait. Pycat didn't freak out when he saw Z-Freak in the ward. He actually baited him in. Started a crazy fight and ended up winning it.
That was an impressive display of fortitude coming up from Mama's boys, to be sure. And now this will give, it doesn't give them the farm on the Naga, which they desperately needed. She died very, very early in that fight to the Omni Slash. However, it will give some room to work with now as everyone from Complexity is just respawning. Lina, who just got the Shadow Blade, will pick up 1.2k gold on top of that. So this is a pretty good start for Weeha. He could keep this game even. We'll see.
Yeah, during that fight, that was like the most, there's like three other targets for that last bounce of Omni Slash to go on. Of course, it hits the Naga. I'm pretty sure she would have lived. Oh, Chessie.
Chessie is going to get destroyed by Weeha's Shadow Blade. Wow. Meanwhile, they're actually going to find Z-Freak. I think they dusted him up. They did. The Ensnare will fly through, and this should be a kill for Pycat. Nicely done. Now look at some extra gold going his way. Like, Complexity had this, like, amazing early game lead. How much were they up by? About 5,000 net worth. And since then, they have gotten, like, one or two kills, and they've been getting destroyed in a lot of these engagements. A lot of that has to do, I think, with Weeha and the Treant Protector keeping everybody alive.
Yeah, Weeha had an amazing laning phase of about the only good one on their side, and once he started rotating around level 11, they just started picking off kills and doing good things.
And so where do you go from here now, if you're Complexity? You keep dying a lot of these team fights. You don't want Pycat to continue to farm. How do you kind of navigate this next couple of minutes here for Complexity? What do you do in this instance?
I would say try to get, like, because that wasn't even a 5-on-5 fight. Swindle wasn't there until late, and I'm not sure, but Swindle picks up the Midas after the blink. They, I guess, want to take this later, interestingly enough.
I don't know if that's the best idea. Swindle is going to walk through his own jungle. Little does he know that Sox is nearby, but he's the only one, so he'll be fine. He did pick up the Midas, as you mentioned. We'll see what he goes for next. Something like an ore, I'm sure. Utility brew pickup is pretty damn solid. He'll maybe get a BKB later, but I don't think he needs it now.
I think we've seen Aghanim's Brewmaster, like, as a normal pickup in solo, what, like, since TI3?
Been a while. I've seen it a little bit. They have picked it up. Every now and then I'll see Brewmaster picks. He'll pick up the eggs. I think it's still pretty damn solid. It used to be just duration increase, but now with the change to, like, being able to use your Thunderclap and all that stuff when you're in your split form, is pretty damn amazing. So we'll see if that's going to be the case here. I imagine he goes for late game, if anything.
Yeah, no, the limps in Viz middle, but it's about to wear off here. It's interesting.
He's going to go on Weeha, I think. Yeah, they're going to make it go. There's the track up now. He'll get off the LSA. Dreamcoil's not going to go. Finally, it will. We'll go ahead and jaunt his way out. There's going to be the Blaze Fury on top of the Treant Protector, which will pop up the Living Armor. Ooh, the song? Can he get out alive here? They even get the Courier as well. They did get the Battle Fury as that happened. Weeha is going to survive as a great initiation from Sox, but they're going to get turned on here. Boulder Toss will fly. There is the Living Armor. They even take it off with that Purge Magic and Dispel Magic coming through. They'll take down the second hero. That'll be, of course, Pycatter falling down to the Omni Slash command with the Battle Fury. Three dead. Great turn from Complexity. And suddenly, this is what you talked about. Fighting is five. They find a good five-man fight and they'll take three heroes. Sure, they'll have to defend top while this is happening, but this should mean that it's going to be Roshan for Complexity or Grant.
Yeah, it should be. That was just a good lucky Invis rune. Got him middle, got the easy initiation. Now, we are a really good ult by Pycat, but wasn't enough when you're going up against two blinks and track movement.
Yeah, that's true. They can't quite get away from that, even with... They needed to leave, I think, a little bit earlier, but unfortunately...
Ooh, they know they're in Rosh, though.
Yeah, this is going to be tough. Yapzor is looking to come in with his Overgrowth. I don't think he is quite that ranked. He does. He can get it on Swindle, but that'll be it if he walks in like this. The Treants are going to be walking through here as well as Complexity. Will they lose this Rosh? Will they lose this Aegis? Who's going to grab it here? There's the Overgrowth coming through. They haven't lost Rosh yet. The Yules will come out. Chase will be able to pick up the Aegis. And now the Yapzor is going to get chased down, more than likely die. The Nature's Wrath will come through. He'll actually use the Nature's Guys. He might actually live out of this. And Complexity are going to back together. They're not looking to fight this right now. Weeha's coming in looking for that two-man LSA. He might find it. Yules will come. They'll try to find Swindle. Looks like he will get caught. Laguna Blade will fly, and that will be an easy kill. They will lose just Swindle for the Aegis. Maybe not. They might lose Z-Freak as well. The Treants are going to be able to come in, and he will TP away just in time. They didn't have a stun up. And we wasn't quite there. So Aegis for Swindle, Roche for Swindle. I think that's not a bad trade. It's all said and done.
Yeah, I think both teams will take it, because, I mean, obviously Complexity got the Roshan kill and that, but Dire's team's going to be able to get a tower and a kill out of it. And yeah. We have Radiance on Naga now.
Yeah, this is going to get a little bit harder for Complexity. The ult will come through. Limp's actually very low. He won't be able to blink now. He'll be able to phase shift this. This is on the LSA. Now there's going to be Chessie coming through as well. Disruption will save the life of Mossbreed, but only for a moment longer. There's going to be the Static Storm, or not the Static Storm, rather, the Lightning Storm coming out. Weehaw's going to get Polar Toss. They jump with a clap. They get the split up. They get another kill on the Weehaw, who is a huge target. Now for Mama's Boys, they'll lose him for 60 seconds. But while this is happening, Yopsor will pick up the Treant Agate Scepter. So the Eyes of the Forest is now up and running, and this is going to get that much harder for Complexity. Pretty much map pack going for Mama's Boys, and the ability of Piecat to split push like crazy. This is going to get real hard, Grant.
Yeah, Aghanim's is always super good on tree, but they're going against the Blade Fury Juggernaut, so, I mean, every time he sees one, he'll just be able to chop it down, so he'll have to get pretty creative with his trees.
Yeah, that's true. Well, especially when they pick up a gem. Maybe not before that, but when they get a gem, this is going to be a little bit okay for Complexity.
So yeah, we'll Chessie's actually doing pretty good now, and Weehaw's finding those kills like with the Yules, but right when she comes out of that Yule, she just gets tracked immediately and killed.
Yeah.
Up late in Sotskin.
He's gonna get caught, absolutely. The sounds comes through, the Dream Coil not needed. Yeah, more Track Hold going though with Complexity, and Z-Freak did get it off. Now he's got his back, he's up to almost his Guardian Greaves. Masquerade will actually find the kill into Onskin coming through with his Necro 3 coming out. He'll be able to jump in, find the kill, TP out. Nicely done.
Yeah, I think the pushing power of Mama's Boy with that Book 3 and Naga getting a little buffer got a lot stronger, especially when they can disengage with the Naga Sleep, so I kind of like Mama's Boy position right now.
Yeah, the thing is,
they pick bad fights, sorry.
Yeah, that's true. What do you feel about the pushing power of Complexity, though, rather the deep push power? They have Battle Fury, they have Swindle to jump in with this clap, they have Split Earth, Lightning Storm. It's like they have good deep push, so.
Yeah, like, the later they go, if they win a team fight with, like, a Juggernaut and a Leshrac, the Edict, then they're gonna have an ACI Sum on Swindle next. Mm-hmm. I mean, they'll be able to win a team fight and just push down the lane immediately. They just can't push themselves straight up, it feels like.
Yeah. I have to push all the lanes back out. If they push one or two lanes out, then of course that third lane is going to continue to get pushed on the other side. You can see what's happening bottom lane. They push top and mid, and then bottom lane is getting pushed in by, you know, whoever. Mossgreave more than likely is going to be doing the job with his split push, and then of course there's Piecat. Meanwhile, Yapzor has gone very deep. He's got an Eye of the Forest here, and he's going to walk out and look for Hanskin. Oh, they dropped the sentry down. They see him. They have the gem up as well. He's going to fall. He's like, you've got to be kidding me. I just got this Aghanim Scepter. I'm going to start losing these trees here pretty soon. They have vision of this tree. Z-Freak will take it down with the Squin Blade. Meanwhile, Weehaw will find Swindle over on the river. He'll go down to a Laguna Blade of Weehaw. So nice pickup there.
Yeah, Swindle was pretty deep in there, even though his team was around.
That was awkward.
Lina, I assume, goes Aghanim's next. Maybe a refresher, I don't know.
I'm fine with either. I think Aghanim's is probably the more likely choice, though. Limp will TP up top, they'll try to, like, this is the problem, like you're talking about, they're pushing into this tier 2 mid, and they immediately have to deep push, and just go into one of those other lanes and stop their tier 2 tower from getting taken. It's not the easiest thing in the world.
Yeah, especially Boots of Travel, Naga, and, Nature's Prod, they can push three lanes all they want. It's going to be impossible for that Complexity wanting to five, man. It's going to be hard defending.
And this is before Octarine Core, too, when you think about it. Like, that Octarine Core comes up, your Mirror Images and Mantle Illusions are going to be out every, like, frickin' time. It's going to be so tough to deal with.
Yeah, Complexity is going to have to somehow win a perfect team fight while Nature's Prophet or Naga's not split pushing. I'm not sure how, but if anyone can do it, it's the boys from Complexity.
They got some work to be done here. They still have that Aegis for a little bit of time, but Mama's Boys are playing this pretty perfectly by not really engaging in a fight. They don't need to. Nature's Prophet more than likely going for a Scythe. He has the Ultimate Orb now, so we'll wait and see if that's going to be the item. And of course, he can jump in, get a Scythe off, and then all of a sudden their team fight gets a little bit better. Zoxy was pushing bottom. He's trying to go for, I imagine, a Glimmer Cave. We'll see if that's the case.
I believe some Juggernaut just losing the Aegis right there, picked up Sanjin Yasha. I'm really not sure. I think he just needs some damage. Maybe a Scotty. A Scotty or an MKB is, I guess.
I think that's fair. Damage. We'll wait and see.
That was a good call out there. Chessie backs up what with the Lina and Viz right there. Couldn't see her, but makes a good play.
Yeah. Some pretty good game sense coming out from the boys over on the American side, or somewhat American side. Got a lot of Europeans for Quebec City. Three Swedish people. It's a lot of Swedish being spoken at in the lobby. It was like, oh, this is happening.
And then there's one of the ores. Vlad's on Brewmaster, so it didn't go with the AC quite right away.
But this isn't uncommon for a Brewmaster to pick up the last first, especially with how good this item is now. A lot of people love this item. The changes have been made.
Yeah, I'm surprised after the Might, it seems like they want to go more late game. I figured he'd go for the bigger item, but Puck has a sheep, so that's great.
This is not to say complexity don't have good late game. They do, to a certain extent, but...
No, they're up on both graphs. It just feels like the later it goes, the more buff the Nature's Prophet get, and it's pretty rough.
Yeah, I mean, that's what we usually see. If you're going late game against a Nog, you give her room to work with, and she will inevitably either take you in a team fight or take you in split pushing. And so that's the tough thing. Complexity have to be careful with how late they take this game. Problem is the later this game also goes, is that there's going to be plenty of Eyes of the Forest here coming out for the Tramp Protector, which is good, but it's going to be tough to walk into the enemy jungle and try to get... essentially, wherever they're walking, they're going to get caught if they're not smoked up, is what I'm trying to say.
Yeah. Oh, Dark Green Gray. Dead.
Which is exactly what, I mean, they kind of baited, they'll get the gem, there's going to be the great disruption coming through. Droomquill will come out, but it actually misses onto Weeha, who's disrupted. They'll get a double kill, they'll get the gem and get out. Again, you walk up high ground with no vision into the enemy jungle, where they have Weeha standing right there on top of the Eyes of the Forest. They're going to see you, and you're going to die.
Yes, here we go, and look at this thing just push you now.
This is going to be huge. Looks like Mamba's boys might be able to take this game and get the first win in 8 games that they've, of course, played here. Not just this tournament, but many tournaments as well. The Axe is now done, as you correctly predicted for Weeha. They'll be able to take that tier 2 in the middle lane, and the last outer tower for Complexity is right around the corner in this top lane as well. We'll wait and see if that's going to be the next objective, and it looks like it will be.
Yeah, I think they're going to do that, and Massacre, if he wants, he can TV bottom and start pushing that, and then just TV back 20 seconds later.
Complexity had such a good start, and then they took one or two bad team fights in the enemy jungle, and it just kind of all went awry from there. Not to say this game is over yet, but after that last engagement, you saw what happened with just losing two support heroes. They immediately lose a tier 2 tower mid lane, and there's pressure on their tier 2 tower top lane, and they have to deal with even more Eyes in the Forest. It did smoke up, I'm not sure if it was scouted out. Jungle will continue to farm up the Ancients here, and they're gonna head down to their bottom lane to try to find a target. Moskari is not the hero they want, but if they can grab a kill, it's better than nothing. Meanwhile, Zoxka is gonna be running through up the high ground. Looks like Swindle and Hansuke know this is happening. They'll see Zoxka as he's gonna walk into the Roche pit. Swindle will about to jump in here, jumps in clap, they'll get off the Hex too. That is a dead Shadow Demon. The kill, a kill is better than nothing. They almost find Weeha as well. Z-Freak might just see him. I think they pigged him out, but they can't quite chase him down, as again, their lanes are getting pushed.
Yeah, I think he might have been dead if he didn't get that Shadow Blade before the,
Oh, he's still gonna be dead. You're gonna get the Sans off, the Splinter will come through, and Weeha's gonna fall. No, the Yule Scepter comes out. They'll just get him right quick down the Laguna Blade. Blimp will be able to just go ahead and jaunt, or rather use that Patient to try to stay alive. And they will lose that Tier 2 tower top lane, but they get a much needed kill. With 70 seconds on the sideline, Lina does not have buyback. She's 96 gold away, she's not quite there. They will lose the Tier 2 tower mid. Pressure is still coming at the other two lanes. The Necrobook top lane going to work on his Tier 3, and down bottom, the Catapult getting ever so close to that bottom Tier 3 tower. And now Complexity, they're in a rough spot here, Grant.
Yeah, they're Complexity pushed in from both sides. They're pushing in middle. Without the Lina buyback, though, worse.
This is gonna be interesting to see who comes out on top. They've already used the edict here. Tier 3 tower bottom lane is gonna go down. Oh, the Salt comes out for PyCat beautifully, stopping any TP back or any sort of pushing. This melee rack's top lane drum is gonna be popped by Masquerade. They're going to work. They're not backing. They're going to work, and they get the buyback from Lina down. Swindle's in trouble. Disruption will fly. Zoxka will get jumped on, but this is a big fight going the way of Complexity. Can they get the ulti off? No! They lose the Brewmaster before they get the split off. Now we have Will fall. Chesky gets the dive back up, but he'll get hexed as well. He's in trouble. The Sprout will come through. They're keeping Mossbury back. They have to hightail it out of here. Limp will go ahead and jaunt away momentarily and try to leave. They've lost the Rax top lane. They do not get the Rax mid. Plexity gamble and lose on a push in that mid lane.
Yeah, trying to, doesn't matter what areas you have, trying to not even split push, just out push a solo's nature prop with book three and drums. That's painful.
That's not gonna happen. It's just not gonna happen.
Yeah, Naga just is delaying their pushes, sending in one illusion at a time, just slowing them down with that mishandle and all that, and then perfect song.
That was an impressive display from Mama's voice, even without by that for a little bit of time for Lina. She does die again, but it is really a big deal to get that first set of racks, and they're going to lose Roche as well. Pycat will jump into the pit. He's got the Octarine and he's got the Radiance, and soon he will have an Aegis, or they'll give it to Mossbury, but there's no Lina there for 23 seconds, so they can't give it to her.
And they see Limp with that. Oh, he's
dead. Yeah, he's going to go down. There's going to be the Radiance burn as well as the Hex up, and the Riptide will do enough damage for them to get that kill. Pretty impressive play there from Mama's boys to get vision with the eyes and the forest, but it's going to be Roche for them.
Yep, free kill, free Roche. Eyes in the Force doing with those, the Quelling Blade from Bounty Hunter and Battle Fury from Jug. They saw plenty of vision everywhere.
Yeah, they're going to use that vision to their advantage to continue to put pressure onto the enemy jungle and secure this Roche, which will definitely happen. Now with an Aegis on top of the extra set of racks they have, it's going to be that much harder for Chessie and crew to do a good enough job to keep this game even, so. Chessie's still top of the net worth. Lina does respawn in time to get that Aegis. Well, well done for them to actually have that item. Or that that Aegis for them to actually stay alive with Weeha, who's died twice in a row. But yeah, I think you just put pressure on mid now for your Mama's boys. I mean, you could continue to split push, but they're kind of, I think they're far ahead now. Nah, it's even in net worth, but still they're doing really well for themselves.
Yeah, I mean they're decently. I mean, because they were down and they were already winning fights, and now that they're going up in the gold, they're gonna have to mess up pretty bad to lose this game, I think.
Yeah,
seeing how they've been playing so far, I don't think they're going to do that. Perfect split pushes from the Nature's Prophet. Team fights.
Let's see if they can get into the enemy base and try to find a kill or two. They're probably gonna push top lane to make sure that that's pushed in while they're getting pushed in other lanes. But yeah, I mean, if you're Mama's boys, you can take this nice and slow. There's no reason to rush it, but not to say that you should wait until the Aegis has run out to push. I think they should have some. They should hustle and try to get distracted. But they might get jumped on. There's going to be Omnislash. Soxy will fall. He disrupted Weeha. He's in trouble. Get the Yules up. He does have the Aegis. Chessie looking to fight. There's the split. There's going to be the Split Earth as well as the Blade Fury. They will get that Aegis. And this fight suddenly turning pretty poorly for Mama's boys. Get the Nature's Guys off onto the Tree Protector. The Naga Song will fly. They get off a great Sprout. That'll be onto the Earth and Fire Spirit for the Broolings. Weeha getting chased down. Overgrowth will fly through. And they can't chase any further. Limp's in trouble, taking a lot of damage. The right click coming in. Z-Freak is going to get hexed up as well next. Laguna Blade will fly. There's the Hex on the Weeha. And he'll be able to use himself for the time being. Can he stay alive is the question. Limplock heals himself as well. They'll lose two on Mama's boy's side. Swindle now completely out of mana, but so tanky. Regenning up with the healing ward so effectively. And now everyone else from the side of Mama's boy will back. A pretty good fight coming through for Complexity to keep their base up and alive.
Now this is a perfect jump. There's so many Yules and Cheapsticks going off, but Z-Freak always getting the tracks off. They know where everyone's at, and a good sleep there. So all they had to do was stand up, but they were just trying. I think Mama's boy, after the Shadow Demon died, they were just trying to back up that whole time.
Yeah.
Possible.
Yeah. Really good catch. It was a pretty good overgrowth coming out from Mama's boys, but...
Yeah, when Juggernauts get it, goes Silver Edge.
Yeah.
I don't think anything like too big, just for damage initiation, running away.
I don't think there's a single pass of this game, except for Fiery Soul.
Yeah, like, I mean, the Mantis Purge, if you've been watching fights, every time he's getting a Demonic Purge by Shadow Demon, Quint takes that off, so be a good pickup.
Yeah, I agree. Also, Silver Edge is good too, because you get off the damage reduction, and obviously, got a lesser Mantis too, which is nice, but damage reduction, passive usage. Soxie's gonna get hit up with it. He'll have to Glimmer Cape away. They missed the overgrowth completely. Chessie is gonna go for that play period. He doesn't quite catch Soxa, but here's Z-Freak, which will get this kill almost. Oh, yep, there it is. And now Yasuo's gonna be attracted as well. They're gonna TP in Monster. He needs to leave immediately. They're gonna jump in. No overgrowth available. Now the Omni Slash and the Weehawk will stay alive, but look how much HP is at 66. The Blaze Fury, and they've lost three with no buyback. Nautilus split push top lane, but that is an excellent fight. Coming up for Complexity, they are not dead yet. They're gonna try to turn this around. Chessy trying to win it all on his own. He gets help and will pick up three, and Weehawk is dead for 65 with no buyback.
Yeah, they know he has no buyback. This is a lot easier than last fight when they're like, does he have buyback? We don't know.
Now they do know. They have 100% certainty that he is not going to buyback for the next couple of minutes. They'll drop up the song, but this is only going to prolong the inevitable. Now Monster is going to get hexed up. He will get obliterated. He has his buyback. He might need to use it here. Pycat trying to do his best with the illusions. As you mentioned, get that missed chance up. Go to work. They're going to send another one out as well, one by one. But the creep wave will get cleared up. There's the Guardian Greaves gonna be out, and this Rax will fall, though. Even the game, at least in terms of Rax, the Accurate is gonna be the Spirit Protector and the Shadow Demon. Do they want to continue to fight? There is no other lane they can get. The Sentry Towers are still up and alive. They'll back away. But the demonic purge will come out. Chessy will be able to get out in time. They'll look to go for this 2-2 tower in the bottom lane, but it is now even in Rax, Grant, as the game continues to get prolonged.
Yeah, that was just a perfect pick off, like you said, by Chessy. He just ran into two of them alone, but he's so farmed against those two supports, he can just do that, and the rest of his team showed up, and Nature's Prophet and Lina came in a little bit too late, and it was bad times for them.
Yeah. Luckily, they have those tier 2 towers to work off of. Pycat is looking for Chessy. Z-Freak is going to go ahead and drop down that eye in the forest, make sure he's got a little bit of extra room to work with. And while that happened too, that's very important. That's a good point. They chopped down a lot of trees in the jungle, in the enemy jungle, and their jungle as well, to make sure they have a little bit, at least a somewhat of a vision advantage. Maybe just trying to take down as many eyes in the forest as possible. That pipe is going to come out as well for Z-Freak. It's huge. On top of that, other items getting picked up here for Mama's Boys and the rest of the team. Ace is coming here for Swindle. Onskis is going to be grabbing, I think, a Hex pretty soon. On the other side, Mantis done for Pycat. A lot of items getting picked up here in the last couple of minutes.
Yeah, this track hold's really coming into play now, though. There was Z-Freak having a pipe just out of nowhere after one team fight.
Look at the net worth grab, dude. Literally, like, 3 minutes ago, even. After that last fight, 10,000 net worth. That's what a Rax and track hold will do for you.
Bull definitely had the lead early game, then Mama's Boy brought back, had a pretty big lead. And then Complexity just takes it right back over with two good team fights.
Yeah. This is a big first game. It's obviously a best of three, but still, any lead you can get in this series to get them even closer to Captain's Draft 3.0 is pretty great. And we'll see if Complexity can get there. They'll pick up the Basher now for Jug, which will inevitably be turned into an Abyssal Blade. They're going to try to keep pushing up this top lane where there is the set of super creeps. Chessy will lead on here with the rest of the crew coming in. They're going to try to take this 2-2 tower down. And I think if you're Mama's Boys, you probably just don't fight. You have good team fight, but maybe not as good as what Complexity have, especially with level 3 Omni Slash and all of the items that the Jug has, not to mention the Hexes. Hanskin with now has the Shiva's Guard, which I thought was going to be Hex, but Shiva's works just as well. And they will try to take this tier 2 tower down. They should be successful. Meanwhile, Pycat with the illusion is just pulling the creep wave. Now they're going to have to TP down to the bottom lane to defend base.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Yeah, they might take this tier 3 down. They have the glyph up, but there it goes.
Chessy does not have a TP scroll. Well, Monster is going to get hexed up nonetheless. They have Dreamcoil at the ready. The clap will come through. There's the silence up as well. Monster is still in trouble. Good living armor, but it will only keep him alive for a moment longer. And now it is time to back away with your Mama's Boys. Yapzor pops up the Overgrowth. Soxia will be able to keep you away in time. Limp still on the chase. Yapzor is in this. He's got the Nature's Guise. Limp does not have the gem, so he will not be able to find him. So even though the Jug does not have a TP scroll, they're still able to defend just fine. They'll be able to get back in time, keep their tier 3 alive. Now pushing towards mid.
Just seems Complexity always knows that they always have a purpose for what they're doing. Compared to Mama's Boy, and that's why you see these team fights getting taken. I think that's just them believing in the captain's will. It's like every game we watch, they could be going down, and then they just have a couple amazing plays, and all turns around.
Yeah.
Oh, the chicken might be in trouble, Chessy.
Yeah, he'll get the kill on the courier. It is a 900 net worth courier going down. It actually had a recipe for a Lotus Orb on it, which was going to be Treant's next item. Yapzor, unfortunately, is not so lucky. He will lose that for another 2 minutes or so, 3 minutes. With that down, they maybe want to go ahead for a push top lane. Limp getting caught by some of the illusions, trying to clear out the creep wave. It's bottom? Oh, Twindle's going to get caught out with a Laguna Blade coming through, but he's not dead yet. He's able to blink in three. He's going to try to juke his way through the tree line. He's still in trouble. Radiance will come out. He's got split, but he can't get it off in time. But this the rest of his team is coming. Swindle, can he get the split off in time? Chessy jumps in. Now he's got the Omnis. He's going to find out the Invisible Blade will come through. They can silence up as well. The Dream Quill will come out as well. And we all will fall. Dead for 84. Still no 5x. Doxy will utilize himself up to try to stay alive. The Omnis working on him, but with him up in the air, he will not go down. Yaxi will get off the overgrowth. He matches it off, though. And Chessy continues to go to work and still find three kills in this fight. But down bottom, the split push is coming in. Monstree is going to get the Rage Rex. It might even get the full set. He's going to go ahead and Sprout TP away. What a fight. He actually stops the TP, but that will only serve for him to finish off that bottom rack. Wow.
Yeah, so I one fight by Complexity, but there we go. The Nature's Prophet doing Nature Prophet-y things. And now he has an AC. He can, I mean, Complexity almost just can't five, man. How buff the Nature's Prophet is by himself.
Yeah. It's almost impossible to push into the enemy base now. They're going to have to play keep away, I think, for a long time. Wow. Alright, well.
It's all about who makes the better decision to play game. That seems to be what most games come down to when they're not deathballed.
Yeah, this is getting close. The BKB now picked up for Swindle after getting the aura items, the AC, the Vlads, as you talked about. No Aghanim Scepter, that will be his next item, I imagine. He could go for more right-click and ability, but I don't think that would be the case. Wait and see.
Saskia has all the smoke spot out wards trying to counter everything. They know they have that ward top after they're dead, but they haven't looked for it yet. They've pinged it out a bunch.
Yeah. Yes, he was able to pick that off. Kind of led to a good fight. They'll even get their own good store for Z-Freak. Now there's bots for Chessy. He is essentially six-slotted. I can think of as getting rid of maybe the Point Dagger or the Battle Fury, but especially with the Naga, there's really no need to get rid of the Battle Fury.
Weehaw's got to be very careful, though, with the Lotus Orb on Z-Freak. I mean, he's almost always going to put the Lotus Orb on the person that either gets disrupted or whatever, and I mean, if he ults himself, he's going to die real quick.
Yeah, that is 850 pure damage. You have 1800 health as the Lina, so on top of all the other stuff that you have to deal with, it's pretty impressive. Well, for now, Mama's Boys, they've got Yapsword down bottom. He actually is in base.
Oh, here comes the gem, though. Bounty Hunter.
Gonna go the other direction. Gonna head towards this Roche pit. Illusion will come through, they'll clear it up. Wow, that Ancient Wrath as well as the Riptide coming in, but they do pop the Healing Ward, and look how fast this dies, Grant. Chessy is six-slotted, he absolutely decimates this Roche at 45 minutes in, and this is not only Aegis, but Cheese as well. Song about to come through, can they take this? The Edict is bringing it down slowly, Weehaw's gonna jump in as well. The track will come out, but they don't have time to go ahead and finish Roche on for themselves. They'll jump in, Clap will come through, there's the Dream Coil, they pop up the Glimmer Cave coming out, there's the Illusion Orb, waiting Rift in as well. Weehaw's in trouble, they're looking for that Omni Slash, they can't quite find it, they'll find it on the Mastery. They get off the stun as well with the Bash, now Weehaw about to fall. He's got no buyback again. Down for 95 seconds, and Moskri is dead for 72. He can buy back and split push. Now it gets a little bit tougher as they lose two really important heroes for Mama's Boys.
It's interesting decisions by Mama Boys after, like, they lost that last team fight, but they had the split push to fall back on. This time they committed, like, five heroes to the Roche. They didn't even commit it to Roshan, just to standing around the Roche pit, even after the sleep.
Are they going to go for tier 4s here? They have to. They're going for tier 4s right now. They have one creep wave to deal with this because the rest of them are getting split pushed, and they need to keep these melee creeps alive. They have to keep them up and ready to go. The Healing Ward will come out for themselves. The tier 4 is about to fall. They'll buy back on the Nature's Prophet. This might come down to a base race, but Zacha to get caught out. Monstery's fought back. He cannot afford to die. They'll go down for 91 seconds. Can they do this with the creep wave? The song will come out from PyCat. What can they do here? To pop up the mirror images as well and try to keep this game a little more even. Now the tier 4s are gone. The Ancient under attack. Can they bring this down to Complexity? Looking to get this 1-0 victory going the way. Yasper is going to get silenced up as well. The Ancient going to win. There's the Dream Coil, and Complexity will take game number one. Holy crap, what a game, Grant.
What a man. Complexity's decision making every single time just doesn't cease to amaze me. That I was nervous about them going for the tier 4s, and then they get the